Arizona State University's College of Technology and Innovation is hosting a science and engineering festival tomorrow. It'll be a day full of activities to celebrate the power of science and engineering. The event is being held in collaboration with the 2013 Arizona SciTech Festival. Here to tell us more is Chell Roberts, Executive Dean of the College of Technology and Innovation at ASU. Thanks for joining us tonight. What can we expect tomorrow?
A very exciting day, Richard. We have from 5 o'clock to 8 o'clock, we're going to have exhibits, we're going to have food trucks, we're going to have hands-on activities for the community. We're a college of makers. That's what we do, is produce makers, and we're tapping into the maker movement, where we have fabrication equipment that has come down to a technology level where the community can engage with that equipment to make and prototype and build things.
Fabrication equipment, I guess, I mean, the new hot thing is 3D printers, but you're trying to get people not to see science as a out there phenomenon, but something that they can try to get excited.
Yeah, something they do and something they engage in. So we'll have exhibits and hands-on participation activities like build and launch a rocket. They will be building solar and wind-powered cars. We have a build a bridge and see how much weight you can put on it. But we also have entertainers coming. So we're going to have a DJ that's going to produce geek rock. That sounds kind of fun. We also have a famous author. Michael Hirst will be presenting his Unusual Creatures project. And so with that project, we see some of the most bizarre animals in the world. And at the same time, he produces and performs songs that are inspired by these creatures on some very odd musical instruments.
What age range are you aiming for? We're talking like you're trying to get middle school and high school kids interested in this stuff?
Well, certainly that's important from a science and technology standpoint, is getting more students interested in science and technology. We think that's important. But this festival is open to the community, so it's all ages, all the way from very, very young to like our age.
5 to 8, no charge, I'm guessing.
No charge. Come and enjoy.
How are we doing in the making department in the United States? How vital is it that we produce young people who are interested in making things?
Well, making is a hook for people. They really enjoy doing that. It's important because we're looking at competition around the world, where a large percent of the gross national product of other countries is being put into science education, perhaps more than here. And so we want more students to engage in science and technology from an economic standpoint, just for us.
And I guess we think of science and technology in the abstract, the chalkboard filled with equations and numbers. Do you find that is daunting for many students as a barrier to entering?
Well, it is, and we've created a number of pathways in science and technology, so it's not just equations. That's how I learned when I went to school, but actually creating and making things. So we learn how to produce, to create new economies, to make products. It requires different types of mathematics, so many different pathways, many different entry points.
How do we get, well, I guess we know that these hands-on exhibits, these hands-on experiments get children excited, students excited about figuring out how to transfer the ability to make something into the equations and vice versa.
Oh, they certainly do. We find that when people get the opportunity to try to contextualize their knowledge and do something to make an impact, to make a difference, whether it's in the environment, whether it's with a new product, whether it's with healthcare solutions, a broad variety of ways people can engage. And I think when people find the opportunity to make real impact and do something, they get really excited. We've had students that leave the campus starting their own enterprises, their own companies, because they see this exciting opportunity, where they didn't ever think they were going to do this in the beginning. They thought they were going to run off on some other different career.
Wait, so you're saying that there's a chance to make people want to learn?
Oh.
Want to learn and make learning fun.
Yes, I think that's really the important part about learning, getting people engaged so they actually do something with their knowledge. It's not passive learning, it's very engaged learning. Get your hands dirty, make, create, build, invent, explore.
And then eventually you have to get to a chalkboard and make some equations.
Yes, there have to be some equations. You're going to have to learn some theoretical principles to make this all reality. But like I say, a different blend.
And I guess, try to bring the United States back into or continue its status in the innovation world.
Yes, we are leaders in innovation. A lot of countries want to copy us because we are leaders, and they're trying very, very hard to do that. And that's why it's very important that we maintain our competitive first place position.
Excellent. And there'll be food, and there'll be games and music.
Oh, definitely. Entertainment, food trucks.
Not a chalkboard in sight.
No, not a chalkboard. It'd be hard to find one.
Excellent. Joel Roberts, we'll see you out there tomorrow. We're going to really pack viewers' days in tomorrow. We'll see what's coming up the entire Friday. We'll get you going.
Well, thank you, Richard.
Thank you.